have started a research project with Dr. Anderson on a disease that affects amphibians called chytrid fungus, or
Batrachochytrium dendrobatitis.
So it is a specific fungus that grows on amphibian skin, and it basically blocks their electrolyte transportation, so it gives them almost like a cardiac arrest, like they can't breathe. Scientists started to realize that there was a major decline in amphibians worldwide, and once that started, they started to look into why is this happening.
So one of the things we've been theorizing is that because we've gotten so much, so many more frogs and things, that it's one of our the other property we're studying. We're wondering if maybe there's a higher rate of chytrid infections here, and that's sort of accounting for the lower sample size that we're getting at this property.
You know, things work their way in, but they can't quite work their way out. So we always come back within 24 hours to check them after we set them.
Ridiculous. Yeah, it's always fun to see what we collect. Like we were saying, that you come down here for one thing and you might not necessarily find the thing that you want, but maybe you'll find something else, which might inspire other ideas too. Tadpole!
Oh, he's a big boy, you're right.
No, that's a green. That has to be a green. It's probably a green frog. For the most part, a green frog is going to be a lot smaller than a bullfrog at this time of year. So a bullfrog is probably going to be almost the size of my hand.
Rachel's our resident environmental science expert. I'm more of like the fungus molecular biology guy. So Rachel's out here. She's the frog-eyed deer.
And he's partway through metamorphosis. He has his back legs.
The Primmer Outdoor Learning Center was a generous gift from Merle and Margaret Primmer. It's a very diverse property. We have a number of different ecosystems represented here. We have a beautiful 15-acre wetland. There's a great opportunity for students to study conservation biology, learn more about biological diversity, and also study the threats against those species as well. Definitely the vision of the Primmers for the gift to Capital was focused on research, student research, and other kind of creative educational opportunities.
So my favorite part about Primmer specifically is that there's a variety of different types of wildlife you can find down here, as well as different plant species, because of the multiple different ecosystems that this property supports. So you have everything from the wetlands over here to the extensive forest and stream here, which you can't really see right now. But yeah, anything that you can think of, you can probably do it here.
We take swabs of sort of like the leg parts and the bellies of the salamanders and frogs we get, because that's usually where they're infected, is on their legs and stuff like that. We're gonna be doing some qPCR, some genetic sampling of the swabs that we get to see if it matches any of the strains of chytrid fungus that we've read about and learned about in some of our literature review. There's not a whole lot of study that's been done on the Midwest and amphibians here, so.
Today we are in the lab doing some DNA extractions. We are taking the swabs that we collected on both of our study sites. We are breaking down the cells so that we can extract the DNA from our samples, so we can take it out and test to see if it is chytrid the fungal disease that we are looking for. We had a total of 96 samples from both properties. Additionally, we found that 10 of those samples were positive for chytrid.
So one of the biggest questions we kind of get when we talk to people about our results is sort of like, what does this mean for the amphibian populations we were sampling? Unfortunately, because chytrid is still a really new pathogen that is only really getting to be understood by scientists, we don't really know what the danger is here. Different species are affected very differently. There are some species of amphibian that are essentially immune to chytrid. There are other species that are very, very vulnerable. That's just different because of differences in their biochemistry, their physiology, their anatomy, things like that. So this has been a really unique project. Not a lot of other projects that I've done have really let me go out into the field and do like data collection there. Developing the methodology, going out and carrying it out in the field, carrying it out in the lab, and then presenting it to everyone, basically from start to finish, was like really, really unique. And sort of gave me a lot of insight into like the scientific method and being able to apply that to something just outside of my classes.
I'm still very hopeful, even talking about something that we don't have like a definitive answer or reason to why this disease might be happening. I'm still hopeful that even adding any additional information to help with scientists' understanding about this disease will eventually lead to possibly being able to help protect them from infectious diseases like this. I hope that I can continue to work on protecting wildlife in this sort of way.